Alright, so this is the second video. Today we're going to discuss how we can make these details. Firstly, I will add here an loop cut. Let's see what we will get here. Let's make a knife here and some loop cuts here. And move in the Y and using the knife. This is one method. It may work, may not. Let's see what we will get. And add some edges here. And let's join this vertex and these two vertex. I will join using J and J. Let's duplicate this one and move to the trash, which will be here. And after that, I will apply this mirror modifier. And let's make sure that we haven't any duplication. That's fine. So assume that we have a circle or cylinder here with diameter of 8 centimeter. So how we can make this? So I will make a circle with 0.4. It's fine. And vertex with around 16. And move to be here in this place. And after that, let's select all this and delete. Let's see what we will have. It's 16, so the same. Here, add circle and move in the X and scale. If you want more space, you can scale in these areas. Scale shift Z and move here. After that, extrude scale for a point and extrude like this. Let's say it will be 1 meter, so it's extruded 1 meter, and we don't want this. It will be go to the trash. And let's see what we have. We can fill it. And after that, we have something. We have here an bar, or I mean there is here for this point. We have this area, so I will select all of these elements and scale in y.8, scale in y.6. And I will slide again here to make it even. Slide minus 1 to 1 and slide 1 to 1. Let's see. I will delete all of these artists. or we can make something different. We can connect. Let's delete. So I select the two vertex here. I mean all of these three faces, and bridge. Again, we want to dissolve and select bridge. Again, we have two here. So I will select all of these vertex and join with all of these vertex. And another thing, we can now so extrude in the axis, and scale in x 0. Will be like this. And finally, I will select all of these points and add circle. I want to figure how we can in the viewport or the theme search for 3D viewport and edge select edge and grid edge active vertex edge sharp edge edge select edge seam. So vertex select vertex, it will be face edge. All right, add a circle 24 maybe, and in this radius to be 1 to 6 or x 90 degrees, and move here. let's move in this axis and extrude. That's fine. So we have something we can move these points here and this point is here, 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 and this will be scale in Y, maybe 4, and we can go to one edge, and in the edge length it will be 1. So also in the item it will be here, and the scale, apply the scale and apply the rotation. So in the Y we may make it 1.1, which is 1 meter and 10 centimeter. That's it for now. And that's it. I think now we are done. Let's move it to be here. And 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 that's it. So we have something to fix. Move in Y. Move in Y. That may happen. As you know, this is live session and it may occur some problems. It's usual. And it may be helpful for you to know how to solve these issues. And that's it. And now we have made this model from scratch using only Blender native tools. And some free add-ons. We can add the solidify, or I mean subdivision surface. 2, 3 and smooth, it will be fine. Let's see if we have added here the subdivision surface. I hope it will not crash. So it needs some edges, so shift in. Let's see what we have here. We should delete all of these vertex. That's fine. And that's it. This also must be moved here. And we have now modeled this from scratch. I hope you enjoy this lesson. See you in the next tutorial.